فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. My brothers and sisters, I'm speaking to you from the city of Bradford in the northern part of England. And I have a message that I would like to share with you today. It's connected to something that is very, very important. Many people are unhappy, not because Allah has not blessed them with something, but because they started comparing what Allah gave them to what Allah has given someone else. And therefore, they become unhappy. They become unhappy because they're looking at the lives of others and thinking to themselves, that's what I need. And for that reason, they forget what Allah has given them. And yet Allah has tailor-made the gifts that He chose to bestow you with for you. And He made it for them, whatever else He wanted to give them. Sometimes you're in a situation, whether it's marriage, whether it's business, financial, the financial levels we're on, your health and everything else, we sometimes do not appreciate what we have, not because we don't have, but because we want to look at others. And this is why to compare your marriage with someone else's, your relationships with someone else's, the biggest downfall, it's one of the biggest ways of people losing their marriages or losing their spouses, should I say. The same applies to being ungrateful when it comes to your business, when it comes to your job, when it comes to your health, when it comes to your situation. Some people are very happy. When they witness their friends go out on holiday, they start putting pressure on their spouse or whoever else, we need to go out on a holiday. Not everyone needs to go overseas on a holiday. Sometimes in the country you live in, there may be places right near your house that you've never discovered that would make a better holiday than some of those who've traveled to Hawaii. You know, so remember, do not compare. If you want to break your life, then you start comparing and you start thinking to yourself, you know what, I don't have, when Allah has really given you. Now, what has triggered this? Actually, what triggered it is I dealt with a few cases today of people who have sound marriages, something good, and they start thinking to themselves, you know what, I'm really not happy in this, because they watch what's happening to their neighbor or someone else. And then they don't realize the wife or the husband is actually trying so hard to make things work, and you're just not happy. And nothing makes you happy. The reason why nothing makes you happy is not because people are not trying to make you happy, but because your eyes are fixed on something else completely. Not realizing that a lot of what we see and witness is cosmetic. When people show you what they have online, they're showing you a photoshopped version, a beauty face version of what is the reality. So you're busy thinking that these people have more than what I have, and I'm never going to get there, or I'm not happy because my situation is never going to be there. That is our downfall. Sometimes you have a relationship, like say, you know, when you get married, you realize that the way you've been brought up might be different from the way your spouse was brought up. Their relationship with their family may be different. Some people have a very cozy relationship, very beautiful. So they get along very well with their brothers and sisters and parents and so on. Whereas a spouse may not be as close to his or her parents as you are, and vice versa. For you to think that, you know what, this particular family is perhaps, or my spouse is doing too much for their parents or her parents or his parents, just because you didn't have that type of a relationship in your home, is unfair. It's unfair. So start thinking to yourself that, you know what, I need to live my life and appreciate what the Almighty has bestowed upon me. I need to make whatever I have work for me, and I need to make the most of what Allah has bestowed upon me, because life is too short. We will continue complaining until the day we die if we're not careful. Now, anyway, that was a quick message that I thought I'd share with you. I'm sitting here in this beautiful place, Bradford. They told me it was freezing, there was a lot of snow, and there was. When I came here now today, mashallah, it's quite warm. You notice no jackets, mashallah. And at the same time, there is no snow in sight at all. And I was actually looking forward to it. I came all the way, but alhamdulillah, I came to meet a friend of mine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all ease. Lovely chatting with you today. I'm not going to get a chance to go through your comments, but I pray that Allah grant me the ability to improve myself. And I also pray that Allah grant us all the ability to improve ourselves so that we become the best of people. Inshallah, you'll find this posted on YouTube later on. And until we meet again, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.